Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. This was released yesterday on the 5th of March and details another new low tier, or should I say lower tier, SPAA. It's not as low tier as the new French one that's coming, but it is rank 4 and for Germany. And no, I'm not going to butcher the pronunciation right now, but this is essentially a new quad AA, but instead of 20mm or 37s, these are 30mm, which are probably going to pack quite the serious punch to aircraft around that battle rating. So this is an experimental German SPAA armed with 30mm autocannons, capable of inflicting deadly strikes into enemy vehicles, and is coming in the next major update. It's for the 4th rank, equipped with a quadruple 30mm turret, excellent ballistic properties. However, of course, it has an open fighting compartment. It doesn't seem to have any kind of turret going for it whatsoever. There is a catch with that. It does have those, I don't know what you call these things, that can fold up or down, but we'll probably address that in a minute. Here is some history on the unit if you are curious to know more. And then we have some screenshots of it. There it is with the, shield paneling, whatever, down. And then here is a shot with it up, where the forward one is still down, allowing it to aim forward. Very similar to the VFW, and where you can protect the sides and rear, at least somewhat, with those sheets of metal. So this unit is, in fact, in many aspects, quite similar to its close relative, the Whirlwind. But it's distinctively different from it in terms of firepower and layout. And this will be coming in the Alpha Strike major update, which of course is the next one. You may already be familiar with the no less infamous Whirlwind, which is an outstanding SPAA that this unit is quite close to. There are some differences though, as instead this vehicle is not equipped with 20mm cannons, but rather 30mm cannons. These new cannons, which are modified MK-103 guns, possess practically the same ballistic properties as their aerial counterparts. As a result, the unit can not only down enemy aircraft with greater ease than the Whirlwind, but can also pose a significant threat to ground targets as well. Thanks to the availability of sub-caliber rounds, you'll also be able to effectively engage even more heavily armored targets without necessarily needing to outflank opponents and hitting them in the sides or rear. This substantially increases the unit's versatility in battle and allows it to support allies in more ways when hostile aircraft are currently not present above the battlefield. You may have noticed some changes in the layout of the fighting compartment of the unit compared to something like the Whirlwind. Unlike a regular turret, the quadruple guns were covered by side skirts that provided anti-fragmentation protection at best. In the combat position, these skirts would open to allow for the guns to traverse horizontally. This is the position that we've decided to model the unit in War Thunder, which provides better aiming angles, but also means the crew inside are extremely vulnerable to all types of fire. Bear this in mind. Then we have a couple shots of this in varying camouflages. So this is kind of one of those vehicles that I wasn't entirely expecting to see in this update. There's actually like quite a few different of these, I'd say, lesser known German anti-air vehicles that, I mean, the weapon systems don't necessarily differ. Like, I'm pretty sure there is one exactly like this with the skirts and everything that has 20mm and one that has the single 37mm, but those probably wouldn't differ very much compared to the other ones and are probably variants that we would end up getting so far down the road when there's not much need for anything else. And I don't remember how big of a gap there is for SPAA on Germany. I do know that Gaijin really fucked up with their removal of one of their SPAA in the past and their moving of one to a higher battle rating, which opened up a big gap, but I don't remember if they have ever filled that in or anything until now, possibly. I don't know. They don't list battle ratings on this page. But is interesting as it is to actually see another lower tier SPAA, I'm still going to keep saying it, the United States has one of the most egregious BR gaps for SPAA, and it has had it for many, many, many years, and I've not seen them do a single thing to try and fill that in. Even with a very simple vehicle, they haven't done anything about it. Instead, we keep seeing stuff like the skink or stuff like this, or things like the Russian anti-air and stuff, where they just keep getting a bunch of interesting AA vehicles to fill in their gaps that are nowhere near as big as the US gap, and so everyone on the US is stuck with the M42 Duster for about 7 years straight. But yeah, so in other news, the only interesting thing I noticed in the comment section, aside from Stona's blatantly stupid-ass response, was this right here, where someone mentioned that there should be an option to put the shielding up and down while in the match. And despite specifying while in the match, of course, Stona's 5IQ here says you can select this option in the optional module, or it's an available optional module in the hangar. You know, obviously completely ignoring the fact that this person specifically stated while in the match, which I don't think it would be that hard for you guys to do that. A button that just slowly deploys or folds them up, I don't see why that is impossible to add. But I don't know, I guess it's just too much money for your extremely expensive game.